The refinery was closed for almost a month to allow for further renovation and upgrade to its facilities. This investment is part of Puma's commitment to invest in local infrastructure and provide full security for fuel supply in PNG and the region.
To come in on time, on budget, with complexities like erecting and dismantling 20 kilometres of scaffolding within the facility is just massive. But it doesn't happen without the technical capacity or without the drive and professionalism that our people showed.
In the past month, over 270 people have worked 120,000 hours without a lost time or injury during the TNI. During this period, Puma Energy also ensured fuel supplies were maintained, even though the refinery ceased operation for a month. Puma Energy country manager said this was the result of detailed planning and effective management.
In the coming years, in the discussions that I had with the Prime Minister this morning, he sees a very important role for us to play in expanding what we do, not only locally, but also taking the next step in our dream, which is creating Port Moresby and our business in Papua New Guinea as a hub for exporting into the wider Pacific region.
Petroleum Minister Kerenga Kua was also there to celebrate this milestone achievement. He congratulated Puma Energy, saying the government has plans to further develop the petroleum sector.
I can say that we are in a very interesting phase in our country's development. We've already commissioned the PNG LNG project, which has been in production for six years now. We have just completed the Papua Gas Agreement and facilitated for it to proceed. And
the minister was also taken on a tour around the refinery's main control room and various sites. Puma Operations Manager Binoka Hudson says there are plans for more development to improve fuel supplies in PNG and the region.
I would never have dreamt we would be doing these things we are doing, and it gives me confidence that there is more to come. We will be improving our facility and operation 10, 20, 30 years from now that we can hardly imagine today.
Rayon Lakingu National, MTV News.